So we have Harshit here. Harshit has scored 7.5 in his recent IELTS test, and this was his first attempt at IELTS. He wants to go to Ireland to pursue his computer engineering and computer programming course. We are going to ask some questions to him about how he prepared and how much time did it take. And so let's start with congratulating Harshit. Harshit, congratulations to you. My first question to you is, how much did you score in each section?
It was 8 in speaking, 7.5 in listening, 7 in reading, and 6.5 in writing.
Okay, so writing was 6.5 and rest of the sections were 7 or above. And this was your first attempt. You did it with British Council or IDP?
This was from IDP, yeah.
Okay. Now, since all the tests are through IDP, so this was conducted by IDP. All right. So let me start with listening. You scored how much? 8 in listening or 7.5?
Listening was 7.5.
Okay. So this was the first test, the first section of IELTS. And how many questions were you confident about? Like, did you expect 7.5 out of 40? How many questions were the ones about which you were absolutely confident that, out of 40, at least 35 or whatever number?
I was actually expecting 8.5 band or so.
Confident about listening.
Yeah, I was very confident about listening that, I'll get a great band. I'll get 8.5 or 9,
So why were you not confident about 9 in listening? Like, you did one or two questions, there were some guesses that you had to make in the listening section there for one or two questions?
Yeah, some questions were, ambiguous for me. I didn't know whether this was the right answer or not.
Okay.
So while listening, I was confused between one or two options.
Okay. So when you get confused about an option, what do you do?
So I choose the most appropriate one, the most relatable one there.
And you move on. You do not let that thing affect the next question.
Yeah. Because if I let that happen, then I'll lose more marks rather than losing just one or two marks.
Yeah, so that's a good strategy that you should keep moving on.
Yeah.
It does not matter, one or two questions here and there really do not make any difference overall to your listening score.
Yeah.
Great. Anything else about listening? Were you, the environment was good when you went there? Were you supposed to wear the mask all the time during listening also, or how was that?
I think it was optional because the seat where the IELTS test was being held, they were quite discreet from other test takers. Okay. So it was optional, but I was quite comfortable with the mask. And while listening, as you may already know, the speakers, the headphones were very good. So it was a quiet environment, so I could concentrate
there. Wasn't any problem. Okay. Then what about reading? How much did you score in reading? And
reading was 7. I wasn't expecting 7. I was expecting only 6.5 or so, as my reading section was not so good.
Mm-hmm.
But to my surprise, it went to the 7 band. So that was really good.
Did you use some jugaads or some shortcuts to get your reading done?
No, there was no special strategy, just that you have to find evidence of the question in the passage given. Okay. So if you find the evidence, then no one can stop you from being wrong.
Yeah. Okay. No one can stop you from being right.
Being right.
So you looked for evidence first and you then marked the answer. And even when you were not confident, you scored 7, how much? 7 bands in reading. Yeah, reading is always a little tough. And I can say that because I've seen so many people struggling with the academic reading. It's a long passage and the questions are sometimes very overlapping. And so you have done great there. Then comes the part of rewriting. How much did you score in writing, and was the time enough to write?
Yeah, writing was quite easy, I guess, because the topics were of the essay and the graph, both were very easy for me because I have practiced a lot. And I guess there was enough time for me to type and to think about the topic that has been given.
How is your typing speed? Do you type fast or slow, or how is that?
My typing speed is around 40 to 50 words per minute.
Okay. 40 so to 50 was, is a I good guess, speed. Yeah.
It was like it's enough for the test to be given in 1 hour.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. 40 to 50 is pretty much a good speed. Did you practice your typing separately, or this was your normal speed?
No, I guess I didn't practice typing so much. I guess I took one or two tests 1 week before the test, but I didn't emphasize on that much.
Okay. So this was your normal typing speed, but you must have done lots of questions and lots of tests during your preparation, right?
Yeah, that must have helped me with the typing speed also.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So eventually when you type, let's say one or two essays and graphs on a daily basis, you end up developing your typing speed. So typing speed is not a major concern, as I can see. Mm-hmm. All right. Yeah, that's great. What about, so how much time did you give to your overall preparation? How many months?
This was around one and a half months. That's it.
One and a half months. And how much time you gave to your practice on a daily basis?
From the day one itself, I used to 3 to 4 hours.
Oh, 3 to 4 hours. And I heard that there were two trainers training you, me and your father as well.
Yeah, my father as well. He has given the IELTS test twice. So he was able to guide me as well.
Great. So this must be very burdensome for you, you know, managing two teachers.
Yeah, sometimes you can say that two teachers are improvising on my writing skills and so on.
Okay. Was there any overlap that one teacher says this, other says this, and you get confused?
Not really. Before sending you the writing task, I used to get it checked from my father.
Oh, okay. That's how it was. All right.
So every writing task, every essay you checked was checked before my father.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Then it was sent to you.
So he used to correct it also, or he just used to check and tell that these are the 5 mistakes?
Yeah, he used to correct it also. He used to omit some sentences that were unclear, or some grammatical mistake were there. So he used to correct them all.
There was double filter there. Oh.
Fantastic. Double filter, yes. And then I after the two corrections, I used to read the
essays. Think this brings me to the point that if you've got some partner who is preparing with you, and if you can take help, whether he is your father or maybe a friend, I think it always helps, because you get another pair of eyes checking your work. And if somebody misses your mistakes, the other person can point them out. And that's what happens in the real IELTS as well. Your essay is checked by two examiners.
Okay.
So you should.
That was the complete IELTS test I was giving from home.
Would you like to be a teacher like your father for a few participants who want help?
I have no problem in it, because I'm not so busy at the moment. So
this would be interesting. Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll say that I'm assigning to you a father figure. Even your essays before sending to it. Okay, fine. So this is great. And I think, this makes a lot of sense to have somebody looking at your essays apart from your trainer. Because that unbiased feedback always helps.
Yeah.
Okay. Let's talk about speaking now. So how did you prepare for your speaking? How many rounds of mock speaking test you gave, and how was it? There also your father interfered. I mean, not interfered, sorry. Helped or?
Yeah, actually, to be honest, I did not, I guess, 2 or 3 sessions with you online only. That's it.
Yeah. So how did writing help you in speaking? Like when you were writing essays, you got organized. Was there an impact on speaking also because you wrote a lot of essays?
Yeah, maybe you can say that the things we write, we can say them properly as well.
Yeah.
So when we write things, then we, so before writing, we speak, think what to write. And while thinking, that idea gets repeated in our mind microseconds before.
Mm-hmm.
So that repetition is very important, and that will help surely, that will surely help in the speaking tasks.
So your advice to the future IELTS takers, how does it sound like, you know, you are a past IELTS taker and who has fateh hasil kar liya, somebody like that. So what your advice to them would be to focus on writing, which could improve their speaking also?
Yeah, you can say that from the day one of your preparation, just focus on your writing and reading sections. But yeah, as per the individual feedbacks, some may have problem with the listening because they are not acquainted with the accents as well, and many other things are there. But at first, the test taker realizes that what is his or her weak point of areas.
Mm-hmm.
And then from day one itself, they should work on it.
Right. So what were your weaknesses? What weaknesses you discovered during your journey? Like, oh, these are the things I'm not really good at and I must work on them.
Weaknesses were, at first, the weakness was the writing section.
Mm-hmm.
Because I was not aware of the, you know, the pattern and the words that has to be used, the phrases that has to be used. But you helped me a lot because of that. The 11 essays, the 11 standard essays, I rewrote those standard 11 essays, and I was quite okay with writing. But reading section was not good throughout the journey, I would say.
Oh, you were struggling with reading?
Yeah, I was struggling with reading throughout the journey because I'm not really into reading many books.
Yeah.
Also.
That really matters. And yeah, I was also not much into reading before I started doing IELTS, and I used to struggle with reading. I agree to what you're saying. And with the passage of time, if you remain consistent, the way you worked, even when you were struggling, you kept on doing the tests. You eventually got it, you know, true, false, not given, finding headings. And there's quite
sometimes.
A lot of overlap. And to a certain extent, people are not exposed to those kind of questions. So, but yeah, you have done great by, you know, not giving up. I think that's very, very important.
Yeah, that's it. But you just keep on trying and just stay calm during the exam and you'll get a great part.
Were you calm during the exam or you were a little panicky?
See, that's normal human nature. Before reaching the center, I was quite nervous. But after reaching the center, the things were quite okay with me. I was calm by then, by reaching the center.
What did you tell yourself to become calm?
I told myself that it's okay. The test is going to be easy. The test is going to be like the test one of every booklet. So it's going to be easy. Don't panic so much.
You said and don't think about it. And you started doing the test. Like, when you're there in the test room, you cannot really think much.
Yeah, so I thought before the test, I thought that this was only a simple test, book one of any booklet. So
was the test paper any different from the test papers you practiced, or it was more or less the same?
Yeah, it was more or less the same. I guess it was around the band, the level of test three or two. Like, it was not like the test four of each booklet.
Oh, you found that the test four of each booklet was more difficult?
Yeah, I guess that's the trend that test one is easy, then two is difficult, and by the time test four comes, it becomes more difficult.
No. It's just psychology, you know. Many times test one is
Okay.
more difficult than test four.
Okay.
You never
Okay, I
told
didn't
me
knew
that you
that.
used to think like this, and I also never told that. I mean, the sections definitely keep on increasing in level of difficulty, but
Okay.
more or less the test papers are of the same level.
Okay.
So you finished all these books, book 7, 8, 9, 10,
Yeah, from
13.
7 to 11.
Oh, you did all of them.
Yeah, I did all the tests of writings, reading and listening, all of them.
That's fantastic. 7 to 11, 4 books means 4 fours are 16, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 5 fours are 20 tests, pretty much.
Yeah,
So
20
that's,
tests are enough for me, I guess.
oh, great. So this is good. And I think what I found was that you maintained a positive set of mind all through the preparation. There were days which were not as rosy, and you used to struggle, I think, but then you still kept on smiling and telling, okay, I can do it, I'll do it, sort of. I think,
Yeah, sometimes.
yeah. So your parents gave you the right name, Harshit, who is like happy and makes others happy. And I think that attitude really helped.
Yeah, the positive attitude has to be there. If you keep on reminding yourself that you have so many negative things, you can't do this, you can't do that, so that won't help.
So
So
great.
much negativity won't help.
Yes. And did you make your corrections log also, like whichever mistakes you committed, did you write them down at one place?
Yeah, as far as reading is concerned, I maintained not so long, but listening, I guess 2 to 3 mistakes were there, and those were the mistakes that were repeating on my side.
Okay.
So there was no need to create a corrections log for listening and for writing as well. I maintained the correction log for reading only.
So great. Congratulations to you, Harshit. And I think, yeah, what is important is remaining consistent and positive throughout preparation and doing like
Yeah.
at least 20 tests before the exam so that your exam becomes like a routine thing. It does not remain something to be scared of. So I think that is something fantastic. And now you are doing your coding and you are preparing to join a college in Ireland.
Yeah, certainly.
When does your session start there?
I'll wait for next year to come.
Oh, okay. So you've got
Because
like
actually the board exams got delayed this year, so I missed the chance of getting the admission into Stockholm Universities.
So next year you
So
will be going there and you will be
yeah.
using this time to do coding and helping others.
Yeah, certainly I'll learn coding at advanced level so that I can be ambiguous and oh sorry be acquainted with the course.
All right. Good. So all the best to you, Harshit. Keep it up and keep up your high spirits and your josh. And I'll call you to seek your help whenever required. Thank you so much. All the best to you.
Yeah, sure. Thank you.